Larkin is joining us from United Oil and Gas here on Proactive London today. It's been a busy time of it, Brian. I know. Should we start with the announcement of the successful placing of Rockhopper's shareholding? What exactly does this mean? Why is it important for your company?
Yeah, well, Katie, it's good to talk this morning. Good morning. But I think it's been, you know, for a long time we've tried to bring institutional shareholders into the stock, and I'm very pleased that we've managed to secure that in the last few weeks. We have a continuous engagement with the institutional side of the equity market, and for I think approximately 3 or 4 weeks ago, we conducted a non-deal roadshow, and it became clear out of that there was significant support from the institutions for the company, and there was interest in bidding for a Rockhopper stock. Now, whilst Rockhopper weren't a seller, they weren't a strategic long-term holder in the company either. So a small number of institutions bid Rockhopper. They came to an agreement, and Rockhopper were locked in for another 6 months. But United had the option to release them from that lock-in, which we did. They agreed a price between themselves and a small number of institutions. And what we've managed to do now is institutionalize the shareholder register and ultimately remove what was a non-strategic shareholder and replace them with a strategic long-term shareholder. So we feel that we've strengthened the shareholder base by bringing in this small group of institutions, which has been led by Premier Mighton.
Mm-hmm. And lots more news, because I know that you've been provisionally awarded 2 blocks in the UK North Sea in the 32nd licensing round. Tell us about these prospects and their location.
Yeah, well, again, very pleased that we were awarded these licenses once again. We've developed a great track record in license applications, and thankfully this is our third successful award. And we've developed a nice track record of developing assets in that region and divesting them. But ultimately, what we've been granted in this licensing round was three discoveries and one prospect, in particular the Maria discovery, which had previously flowed over 2,000 barrels of oil equivalent. So we'll look now to work that up once we've been granted the formal award, and we'll look to then potentially bring in a partner or divest again.
Okay, so you've got big plans for these assets then, right?
Yeah, well, it's a core area for us. It's an area that we know reasonably well, and we have a great track record in that area of developing assets and divesting them. We did them with the Crown prospect, where it's very similar to the recent award. We awarded that license and 30th licensing round, and we did quite a lot of internal desktop work, my technical team, which ultimately led to a divestment of potentially up to $5 million in that license. So we have a track record of developing assets within that basin, and thankfully we've been granted another award. And once again, it was a competitive bid round for this particular acreage in these particular blocks, which is good, because it means that we've got acreage that there's obviously a lot of interest in, and it would bode well for a farm down or a potential divestment down the road.
Good. We'll look forward to hearing, checking in with you on that one. Let's talk about the fact that you've added to your staff recently as well, Brian.
Yeah, we've padded out our board. We've appointed Iman Hill as a non-executive director. Iman, I've known for quite some time. She brings a lot of experience to our board. Very excited to have her on board and to bring someone of Iman's quality to the team. Again, it's another validation of the development of the company and our strategy and our assets and what's been achieved to date. But Iman has a lot of experience in South America, Latin America, where we've got assets. She has a lot of experience in the greater Mediterranean area, in particular North Africa and Egypt, where we've obviously got our core production license. And she's also a lot of experience in Asia. Couple that with her environmental and social background, she brings a huge amount to our team. So delighted to have her on board.
Good stuff. And for your investors watching this, what can they look forward to in the next month or so?
Well, we'll continue to execute our work programs. We've had such a busy period really since the turn of the year, despite the backdrop of COVID. We've completed the Egyptian acquisition. We've drilled 2 successful wells in Egypt and almost trebled production. We have been granted an extension to our Jamaican license and taken over operatorship. We've strengthened our board with the appointment of Iman to the team. We've also institutionalized a shareholder base, and we've been granted the recent licenses this week and the last licensing round. So we've had an extremely busy period despite the backdrop of COVID. So I think for us now, the focus is to continue to develop the assets. you know, all of what's been achieved in the last number of months has positioned United now as the only full life cycle producer, E&P producer listed on AIM. So we've, over the last number of months, with all the development across the assets and corporately, we've actually positioned ourselves and differentiated ourselves as quite a unique E&P company listed on AIM now. So I think our focus now really needs to be to continue to develop the assets and continue to develop the business.
Developing assets and the business. Thank you very much indeed. That's Brian Larkin there talking to us today from United Oil and Gas here on Proactive.